Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent and Merciful. Today I am going to talk about atheism. What exactly atheism is? Actually, there is a wrong concept about atheism. Even atheists also think that atheism means the people who knows that there is no God exists. But actually, atheism is not this concept. All the atheists, the people who don't believe in God, they don't have a single proof that there is no God. But the actual concept of atheism is that we don't know whether a God exists or not. People of this age, the atheists of this age, try to explain that there is no God, but they don't have a single proof for non-existence of God. They only give the logics that because we cannot see God, we cannot touch God, we cannot taste God, or the things, and they support these kind of logics to prove that there is no God exist. But in fact, the atheists even don't have a single proof of non-existence of God. If there is no proof, according to atheists, that there is no proof for the existence of God, even they don't have a proof for the non-existence of God. So the main concept of atheists is that they don't know that there is a God or not. They believe that if they will find a God, they will believe in God, and if they don't find a God, they will not. That's the main concept what atheism is. Now, we are going to prove and give logics and proofs about the existence of God. First of all, I want to be clear that a thing that we cannot see, we cannot taste, or we cannot touch, is this a logic that that thing does not exist? Is this a rule? Is this a proof? I have a question, a simple question, that a thing that we cannot see, we cannot touch, we cannot taste, is that means that that thing does not exist? Is it a rule? No, that's not a rule. As if we go behind 100 years back or 200 years back, when there was no microscope. There was no microscope at that time, and that time we were not familiar to the bacteria and the viruses. These are all the microorganism things. If we were not familiar, we humans don't know, we have no equipments to check or to see the microorganisms. Was that means that there are no bacteria, no viruses, and the microorganisms? Never. The microorganisms exist before, and but we don't have equipments to see them. This is the logic, that if we cannot see, we cannot touch, or we cannot taste a thing, that doesn't mean that the thing doesn't exist. Number one logic. Number two, I hope you'll understand this, that if we cannot see a thing, that doesn't mean that doesn't exist. Sure. Now, if we go to astronomy, there are millions of stars, millions of even galaxies that we have not seen yet. Even NASA has not seen. So does it mean that these galaxies doesn't exist? No. Simple answer is no. If we will be able to see them, then we will believe that they exist. Now, the next logic is, because atheists always give the logic that we cannot see, we cannot touch, or we cannot taste God, that means there is no God exist. By the first logic I have given, that logic is proven to be wrong, that if we cannot see, we cannot touch, or we cannot taste a thing, that doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. Now the second thing, we believe that the universe is a creation of God, but atheist says that this universe is created by its own. That's the difference. Now the atheist question, if there is a God, we should see a God. I'll answer, as I mentioned earlier, that this universe is a creation of God, not God. And it is also illogical to find the manufacturer, the creator in the thing. For example, this is a watch in my hand. Someone had manufactured this watch. And if someone asks me that this watch is manufactured by its own, there is no manufacturer of this watch, and I say, I resist that, no, someone has manufactured this watch. And he argue that if someone manufactured this watch, bring out the manufacturer from this watch, from this watch, in between this watch, and I will never be able to show the manufacturer from this watch, because he is not in the watch. He is the creator, he is the manufacturer, he is the maker, and he is not in the thing. So the second logic, second concept is that the manufacturer, the creator, we say as God, is not in the thing, in its creation. He is beyond his creation, as manufacturer of this watch is beyond this watch. He or she is not in this watch. If you want to see God, you have to, the second thing, second way you can see God is, you have to go out of this universe, if you can. That's the way you can see God, but I hope you will not be able to go out of or beyond this universe. These are two logics. Third logic. What is the third logic? What's the time? It's 2 o'clock on my watch. You wonder, I got this information from this watch, but this information exists before, the time exists before this watch, but we were not familiar by the time before the watch. So the information collection resources are not only our senses. Mean to say that, in simple words, that if we see a thing, it exists. If we doesn't see a thing, it doesn't mean that it doesn't exist. There are other ways to find out, as we find out the time through watch. We cannot judge the time by our six senses. So there are also many means of information other than our senses. So I request to my brothers, to atheists who say that there is no God because we cannot see God, we cannot touch God, we cannot taste God, and we that's why they say there is no God. So I simply request that you cannot refuse, you cannot deny a thing on the basis of your senses. This is okay. Now we go to the creation of the universe. That is there a creator of this universe? No. Let's say we go to the Eiffel Tower and we see this tall tower, huge tower, and then someone asks, this tower was created by its own. No one created this tower. What will be your answer? No, there were people who worked there and they created, they made this, they worked hard and then they made this tower. But for example, I refuse that this tower was built by its own, and I argue that if there is manufacture of this tower, bring them out of the walls of Eiffel Tower. We can not, certainly not, we cannot bring out the makers or the workers of the Eiffel Towers from the walls of Eiffel Tower, because they are beyond, they are not in the creation, they are not in the manufactured thing. So if we think about the God, then the God is not in the universe, in the creation. God is beyond the creation. And people say, is it logical if someone says that there was some cement and the material which is used in Eiffel Tower was dropped from air and the Eiffel Tower was created? That's illogical. No one will believe that there was cement and the other material dropped from the air and the Eiffel Tower created. No. If a single Eiffel Tower will not be created by its own, then how the entire universe created? I'm not going to prove just my logic. I am going to put some questions in front of you, that there are certain things in this universe like that. Eiffel Tower is not so complicated, even the universe is more complicated than this. Oh, let us say we see the sun. Let's put some questions on sun. If the sun was very far from this universe, what will happen? There will be no crops on this universe, because all the plants need sunlight for their photosynthesis. And now look at the sun. If the sun was closer to the universe, then what would happen? There would be no living being on this earth, on this planet. So the sun is on a distance where all the needs are fulfilled in this earth. There are many things. If the earth is not rotating on degree of 23 degree, then what would happen? The earth will not remain calm. So there are a lot of things. Let's say the birth of child births every year with a ratio. Let us say if this ratio exceeds our disease, let's say if in a year, or for example for 5 years consecutively, only boys born in the universe, what would happen? Then I think a human being will vanish, because there would not be girls, so that the universe keep on growing. There are also other things, like if there is only daytime, then the universe will heat up, and if there is only night, then it would be cold. And there are also most things in the universe that are not we can say that these things are not created by their own. There is a logic behind the creation of everything, and there is the same logic as in electrons, as in our solar system, as in atom, as in solar system. There is the single mind behind all the creation, and that is we call God. I'm not here to just defend my point of view. I have questions for you. You should answer, you should think and do whatever you think about these questions, that how a universe could be created that is just perfect. That universe is just perfect. Everything is perfect in this universe. So if so, then who created this perfection in this universe? There are lot of things you can see that are just perfect. If they are changed a little bit, then the universe will not be like that as we can see it right now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that I'll get answers of some of my questions, if you understand. And I'm really sorry for my English, because English is not my mother tongue.